Space, the final frontier. I haven't done a William Shatner in like so freaking long. Oh well, we'll find out the hard way how bad it truly will be. Hey everybody, I'm Super Pack Jr. Welcome to my stream here on Twitch. Easy for me to say. Well, it is time to play Star Trek the 25th anniversary for Video Game Memory Lane. And I remember getting this game for my birthday back in 1992. It wasn't the 25th anniversary then, because that would be 1991. But Star Trek VI had just come out just a couple months prior to that. And hey, Susan Chaos, I haven't seen your name pop up in my chat in for frickin' ever with a Founder's Badge. Hey, how you doing? Welcome aboard. You're here to see Star Trek, the 25th anniversary NES game from Ultra Games and Interplay. Oh my God. I used to do, a long time ago, back in the 80s, a little comic and occasionally an audio piece called Star Wreck. And my brother and a couple of others would take roles and so forth like that. And of course, I played Captain Kirk because I'm such a pompous ass. And this is like Star Wreck video game. It is purposely bad. You've watched a few Final Fantasy II VODs. Oh, thank you. Appreciate it. I'm enjoying the hell out of Final Fantasy II. I haven't played that game in over 25 years. And I've forgotten how goodly, badly good that game can be. And one of my, Vin, one of my regular viewers, he commented on how poor the translation is. I said, I had to remind him, that's the actual translation from Square. It's properly bad. But there you go. Anyway, we're going to play some Star Trek, the 25th Anniversary Edition NES game. And time permits, we'll also play an older Star Trek game coming from 1982, but we're going to play a 1983 Atari version. Ooh. Probably say to yourself, well, so what? That's right. I have no idea what I'm doing. Anyway, we're going to take a timeout here, of course, as we do everything. We've got to pay some bills and all that kind of neat stuff. So I'm going to find the button over here that says pause. There it is. Hey, Pac-Man. And we're going to run a couple minutes worth of ads. You might be interested in some of this stuff. You might not be. I don't care. You're going to have to watch it anyway. So there. We'll be right back. Probably help if I actually remember to turn off the damn thing, too. Anyway, hey, Seething Chaos, how you doing today? Good to see you here. We've been having a hell of a year here. And, well, let's see. Dryer's still broken. Doing good? Good. If you haven't caught on, we've had some washer and dryer problems. Dryer particularly, because we've burned out two sensors, a couple of fuses, couple times over, the heating element, and that's because our dryer duct, for whatever reason, the design geniuses made it vertical instead of horizontal, and it had been clogged quite a bit. So we got it unclogged. We spent a small fortune doing so, and about three washes later, it broke again. Yay! So we're doing great. You've been extremely busy. Well, I miss seeing you here. Holy crap. Yeah, it's been fun. It's been fun. Hey, if you haven't heard, though, Soothing, London Last finally stood up for the first time in over 400 days, just about a couple of weeks ago. And miss watching live? Well, make yourself at home. We're right here. Right here at the moment. We've changed a few things since I've last seen you. We've switched to OBS because I was one of the 4% of people using a Twitch studio. And I should have been using OBS the entire time because it doesn't take nearly as much CPU time as this. So, yeah. London Last, he's doing a lot better. It's been a rough ride. We got 7 seconds left of ad time. Oh my goodness. People must be purchasing nothing out there. Time's up. My community is back. Where are you? A whole two viewers. Hey, two viewers. I know one of them. Who is it there? Yeah, okay. Anyway, we're going to play some Star Trek in just a second here. We've been having a, like I said, we've been having a bit of a time here with things breaking all over the place. And, well, things breaking all over the place. And, oh, by the way, things have been breaking all over the place. But that's just that. So there you go. Anyway, let's turn over to the console. Let's see, where's the console button? It's right over here. There's no music. I've already had the game running. I'm going to go ahead and reset this thing. Because it is, if you haven't played this game, you really have missed out. And it actually got some good ratings when it came out. I'm just not one of those believers. Anyway, Star Trek from Ultra Games, which is a division of Konami. It was developed by Interplay. It appeared on numerous platforms. We're going to play the NES version because, you know, we are retro here, after all. And artistic copyright, 1991 Paramount Pictures. Oh, my goodness. And Ultra Games is a registered trademark of Ultra Software, whatever that means. Okay, here we go. This is important stuff now. This is the cold open. Captain, now entering Sigma IOTA system, whatever that is. Slow to impulse, Mr. Sulu. I do bad impressions. Aye, sir. Purposely. Ooh. Ooh. My dinner's acting up. Captain, we are encountering an area of next. Very unstable turbulence. Well, no shit, Spock. Scan sector. Sensors indicate unusual fluctuations in gravity and magnetic fields. They appear to be centered next near the planet of Sigma Iotia. Yoshia. Whatever the hell they're called. And look at that. What up, what up, what up? Oh. Captain, there's a big hole in space. And you're it, Mr. Chekhov. A-hole. Fuck. Readings are fluctuating. Greatly. It may be some kind of dimensional hole. It is definitely... Yeah, I know it sucks. So did Koenig's, okay? Or Koenig. Sources of the disturbances. Even Koenig said his Russian accent was completely broken. Captain, something is pulling us towards the hole. They're calling it a hole. Keep that in mind. All stop, Mr. Sulu. No effect, Captain. We're still being pulled in. Nope. Didn't say in yet. In. There we go. The gravitational field is growing. You look so happy saying that, too, which is strange. Exponentially. Literally. Now, warp 3. Just like Chekhov's, yes. Sulu, emergency reverse warp. What the hell is that? Emergency reverse warp. Scotty, we need more power to the engines. And then turns over to Scotty, who also couldn't do an accent. They're burning up as it is. I don't know if I can. Next card. Do it. I can't do it, Captain. Whatever, Mr. Scott. It's like the Price is Right lights. Warp 9. Warp 9. I love the music. The field is bending space and time in our... Oh, my God. Immediate location. Aren't you getting dizzy just going... Captain, the stress from the pull is tearing the... Scotty on the bridge, one of the worst parts of... Yes! Ship apart! I have to shut down the engines before they melt. Melt? Just give us a few more seconds, Mr. Scott. Captain, your toupee is not handling the gravitational flux. This may not be a good thing. Captain, it's gone. Ah! Whiplash. Lieutenant Uhura, open a hailing frequency to Starfleet. I'm not doing Uhura's voice, okay? I'm trying, Captain. But there's no response. All channels are silent. So Captain Kirk must be an owl for his head to turn around like that. Not surprising, Captain, our navigational computer does not recognize our position. We are no longer in known space. No, I'm not going to sound like Nichelle Nichols. Can't forget about warp core breaches. Yeah. Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its 5-year mission. To explore strange new worlds. To seek out new life. And new civilizations. To boldly go where no man has gone. Oh my God. Before. They try so hard. Oh, I love it. They try so damn hard. These are the people that are responsible for this mess. I was so excited when I got this, too. Jason Snake Magnus. Okay. Oh, boy. Now it's time to grab that controller and start the game, I guess. My goodness. Okay. Let's start the game. It's not the worst game out there. No, it's not. Well, here's the thing. Captain's log, Stardate 2831.3. While investigating the strange gravitational disturbances in the Sigma Eocia system, the Enterprise was caught in a dimensional gate, unable to break free from its intense gravitational field. Macy, go on. We were transported far away into the uncharted reaches of space. Now we must find our way back home, wherever that may be. Well, it's there somewhere. Ah! Scotty, damage report. Fuck you, Captain. No, the mains are shut down. We're running on backup. Powder right now. Why can't we engage the warp engines? Because you, like, broke them. The strain on the engines fused all our dilithium crystals. I cannot return power until we replenish our supply. This is so hard reading it this way. It's like three-word cue cards. Captain, based on our current rate of fuel consumption, our orbit will decay in 2 hours. Oh, perfect. That's, we got a minute. We got an hour and 45 minutes left. Hey, great. Thank you, Mr. Spock. Doesn't anybody have any good news for me? Yes, the deadly flag. I actually played that last night to get refamiliarized, and I forgot about the dead. I lost Dr. McCoy, like, right off the bat. Dilithium crystals on the planet. Coincidentally, the dilithium crystals on the planet's surface, we can just go ahead and scoop up. Have Dr. McCoy meet us in the transporter room. We've got to find those crystals before it's too late. Okay, as we go into the turbo lift, Captain, our most recent sensor report revealed a large deposit of dilithium under a very unusual structure. It's been a few years since I played this. It appears to be manually constructed and similar to the Aztec pyramids of ancient Earth. Any speculation as to its origin? Insufficient data at this moment. However, it is generating a lot of energy. Generating a lot of energy. Yeah, that's what you hear Spock say all the time. Energize! I get to push the buttons. Oh, I push the buttons, and I get to pull the thingy-things. Oh. They did try really hard on this. Do the SNL version of Kirk? It's just a TV show. Okay, so here we are. Now, what I loved about this game was the controls. There they are. Tricorder readings reveal a large structure about 157.03 meters to the north. Readings also show a human settlement to the south. So as we walk around, they just kind of haphazardly walk. I have direct control over Kirk, you see. But they just walk wherever they damn well please. Okay, so we're going to watch out for the deadly flowers. As we head towards the settlement to the south. Now, I have a phaser. I can go doot doot to and shoot the flowers. Let's take a look at my menu. Well, I have Spock, I have McCoy, I have use item, I can beam up anytime, and I have stun. Stun full. Set phasers to full effect. And then they, let's see. You can't shoot. You can't shoot the flower. I can shoot Dr. McCoy. And I can do that. Let's turn this back to stun. Set phasers to stun. Okay, so anyway. Let's go down to the human settlement, shall we? And we talk to this fine person. Who's already talking to me, whether I realize it or not. The medicine man can prepare you for safe passage through the forest. That's a forest. Okay. What, Macy? What do you want? Oh. He seems to be performing a ritual dance, Captain. Thank you, Mr. Spock. Thank you for stating the obvious. Either that or he has bad hemorrhoids. Ah. You must be the medicine man. Greetings, strangers. I hear you wish to make a pilgrimage to the Holy Temple. I can make a repellent to the bloodworms in the dark forest if you bring back a shooting flower from the plains to the north. Ah, I can do that. Use my trusty doot-doot phaser. Okay, I can't walk over the plants nor through the fire. Or through that thrush, okay. Let's do things first. Let's go ahead and get one of those lovely little deadly flowers so we can proceed with this game. No, like we're actually taking it serious. Okay, let's go ahead and grab the flower. This is a very interesting plant, Jim. Shall I take a sample of it? Yeah. Okay, we got our sample plant. I love how they actually use the music from previous Star Trek episodes. Okay, we gotta get past him. Okay, there we go. At least two of us made it inside. Now we got all three. And he says, I see you have brought a shooting plant. Place it in the fire. I gotta do everything. Okay, place it in the fire. Use item. Plant. Oh my God. Take the jar of repellent. He made a jar. How about that? Below the fire pit. As long as you keep it, no bloodworms will harm you. Yay! Shall I add the repellent to our inventory, sir? Since when do you call him Sir Bones? Yes. All right. So, yay, mission accomplished. We got a jar of repellent. Now let's talk to the other fine creatures of this. There's a lot of cats. Okay. Nothing strange about this at all. And he says, beware of the swamp beast. And you say, the medicine man can prepare you for safe passage through the forest. Yeah, we've heard that. We've heard that before. Okay, we'll go this way now. What's with all these cats? Beware of the swamp beast. Okay, we've heard that. No dancer here, so it must be safe. Oh. And he says, welcome to the village of the cat people. How can we, and that explains all the cats, I guess. How can we help you? What do you know about the large building to the north? It is the temple where the druid prays for good weather. However, the druid was killed by a beast from the swamp 3 suns ago, and the Eye of Kakos was lost with him. Is that all? What is the Eye of Kakos? Well, you know, it's an eye. It's Kakos. The eye will allow entrance to the temple. If you can recover the eye, you may make the... You may make that. Thank you for the chicken dance. All right, chicken, settle down. Settle down, chicken. All right. Let's get back to the script. What the hell? Okay. Well, that's a fine scene. Okay, let's get back to this. Thank you for the chicken dance there, Vin. Appreciate it. Where were we? Yes, the eye will allow entrance to the temple. If you can recover the eye, you may make the... We've still been waiting on the... pilgrimage to the temple. Oh, you're done talking. Okay, cool. Great. Wasn't really paying attention. Star trekking across the universe. Oh, you can go through that way. Oh, cool. What do you got to say? The medicine man can... It's like they have very few lines in this. Would you prefer that he talk slowly and put a fake Canadian accent? Well, about that. Okay, this room is full of fire and cats. Anything else of intense value here? Apparently not. Okay, cool. So the cats get their own hut. Remember, they are the cat people. Okay. All They don't speak to anyone but Kirk, I've noticed. The medicine man can prepare you thing. Okay? And stay away from the bloodworms in the dark forest. No problem there. We got our own repellent from the medicine man. Whoa. Bones. Idiot. Get over here. Okay, fine. We'll just go cry in your corner. We'll just leave you back. We'll just leave you be. Okay, so we're back here. Okay. Remember, stunning is good. Vaporizing is not so good. I love that phase. Oh, okay, I see movement. That must be a bloodworm. And that is the dead end. Yep, those are worms, all right. We have our own bloodworm repellent thing. I suppose we can go this way. We sure can. This is like an actual episode of Star Trek. Okay, so that must be the temple. And these worms are just running rampant. Okay, I think we made it. I think we made it through. There's the temple! And there's a tricorder. It appears to be an alien metal of some kind. An alloy resistant to probe readings. Cannot measure its age properly. There's also an indented hole in the middle of it. Perhaps it is a keyhole. I'm so glad you're here, Spock, to tell me this. If I haven't figured it out myself. Maybe if I shoot it. Okay, it doesn't like my phaser. So I guess we have to find a key or something. Okay. So I'd rather have the plants than the stupid Captain. The stun setting is fairly ineffective. Thank you, Mr. Spock, against these creatures. Great. We'll just use you then. Okay, so we made it to the temple. We can't get in because we don't have a key. According to Mr. Spock, there's a big hole in the door that requires a key. Okay, there's an ugly little worm. I'd rather have the plants, to be honest. Okay, dead end. Go this way. Well, maybe we go back to town. We can ask for maybe one of those fine people have a key. Okay, there's far too many worms to my liking. Let's say I was playing this last night. I lost Dr. McCoy like almost immediately. Okay, let's talk to the medicine man. He seems to know a lot. Where the hell did Kirk go? Oh, there he is. Okay. I walk up to him and he says, nothing? Maybe if I shoot the cat, then he'll say something. No. So I guess his purpose is done. I guess so. Okay. So we gotta look for a key to go into the temple. Because our phasers clearly won't work. Deadly spirits guard the temple. Oh, that's good to know. That's good to know. So there's no malevolency as far as spirits are concerned. What do you know about the large building? It is the temple where the druids pray, blah, blah, blah. We know that. And, yep. And K. Okay, we talked about the Eye of Kaikos. Blah, blah, blah. Great. Okay, so nobody has a key. Do we just, what, find one? Make one? Deadly spirit. God, thank you. Really wasn't talking to you, but thanks for anyway. For making me stop. Okay, so as opposed to the shooty shoot. Oh, I almost shot Dr. McCoy. So like I said, this game is interesting. They tried really hard, but you know, where they had Star Wars games, but not too many Star Trek games. Star Trek was kind of like the cerebral science fiction of its time, sort of. Okay, come on, Dr. McCoy. Go to my inventory. I have repellent. Maybe that's all I have, though. Just let the bloodworms go their merry journey. Yeah, there's nothing there. So, in order to get inside the thing, we have to get a key. Oh, hey! Maybe, how you doing? Nice to have you here. We're playing some Star Trekking across the universe. Aboard the Enterprise with Captain Kirk. How have you been? Okay. Back to our tricorder. This could be important. It appears to be an alien metal of some kind. An alloy resistant to... We already read this. Yeah. Okay, good. Indented hole in the middle of it. I have been doing... And I've been busy myself. Been fixing things that have been breaking around the house. We've had multiple instances with our clothes dryer. Doesn't want to work. No matter what I do. There must be a key around here somewhere. Gotta find a key. Maybe there's a key in the flower pot. Or under the doormat. Welcome aboard. Glad you're here. Got some old friends with us today. Soothing Chaos, Vin. Maybe. Okay, we're gonna read the same thing over and over again. A keyhole. Now we gotta find a key. So as I was saying at the top of the stream here, I got this for my birthday. Thank you very much. Thank you, Ben. Perfect. I got this for my birthday back in 92. And I was like so excited all the way up to the point where I turned it on and started playing it. I'm like, okay. Hmm. Maybe if I shoot one of the worms. Well, you know what? I'm sitting around here using stun. This thing needs to be on full. Set phasers to full effect. Now, will it kill the worms? We can't go much further than the thrush. There must be something else we're missing. I got this when I turned 19. Oh my goodness. They mixed up Dagobah with Star Trek. You can't walk in the mess before you have to walk in the grass. In circles. Like I said, I was really excited to get this. It looks stupid. Oh, I killed it. Captain, Starfleet would not tolerate the killing of local life forms. Who's the one holding the phaser, Bones? Shut up. Fine. Know it all. Starfleet, they're not the ones lost. Very happy? Will it be all right? You already killed one. The creature is merely stunned, Captain. It should be back on it. Should be back on its feet in a couple of hours. Oh, lucky for us. I'd rather just vaporize the damn thing, okay? Hey, there's something there. It can apparently traverse through the water. That looks to be something that we may need to get. What's amazing, though, is I try to keep my thoughts together. There's been a bunch of Star Wars games over the years. Now, Star Trek, the first Star Trek game came out in 1982 by Sega, and it was pretty cool. But they really don't. I guess Spock will catch up with us somewhere, sometime. You're over there. Okay, come on, Spocky. There you go. As I keep stunning the local creatures. This would appear to be the abode of the creature. Oh, great. I found the eye, Captain. They're dead, Jim.
Yes.
Okay, now let's make sure. Can we go inside? Thank God, no. So they made a lot of Star Wars games, but not too many Star Trek games. Again, it's kind of it's a different mentality. Yet Star Wars was responsible for keeping Star Trek alive to a point. And just about every other science fiction related thing. Okay. And I love how Spock and Bones are just haphazardly wandering. Making my job that much easier. Oh, I got attacked. And so did Spock. Spock tripped over the thing. There was a clear divide between Trekkies and Star Wars. Yeah, there is, maybe. To this day, indeed. I totally agree with that. And yet, you can still be both a Star Trek fan and a Star Wars fan. My wife and I are both clearly fans of both genres, if you will. Okay. Okay, there are the worms. Now, the stun setting has no effect on the worms. And I love Star Wars. Don't get me wrong. I thought Star Wars was one of the greatest things I ever saw as a kid. But I also watched Star Trek religiously. I am a Trekkie. The funny part is, I stopped watching television. For the most part, when Star Trek Next Generation went off the air. When you consider that's 30 years ago. Okay, you two are the dumbest creatures. Same to this day, even watch the new stuff. Yeah, more Trekkie than a Star Wars fan. Star Wars is cool, but man, I can leave it. I'm going to qualify for Star Wars. Having watched all the movies in the theaters, the first three, I'm talking about when they premiered, not necessarily, you know, episode 1, 2, and 3.
Definitely not those.
But Star Wars, Empire Strikes Back, and Return of the Jedi. Wonderful. I love them. And Rogue One was brilliant. The rest... Exactly, the OG movie. When I saw it, there was no A New Hope. It was just simply Star Wars. And I, you know, I'm one of those dummies who has to have like everything of something. So I had Star Wars on Laserdisc and I had Star Wars on video CD. Yes, there's such a thing. Of course, the DVD set. With the original releases, not with the new stuff, which I really didn't like. Okay, let's use this thing. Yeah, it appears to be... Okay, can we just use... I forgot to use the eye. Fine. Use the item. Eye key. And just like that. Captain, our doorway has... Oh, thank you. You know what? Thank you for telling me these things, even though it's right in front of my face. Appreciate it, Spock. You're paid by the word, aren't you? Ooh. Hmm. We're going to use the tricorder, huh? Very peculiar, Captain. These symbols seem to be some kind of code. And we have a thingy. And then we have another thingy. Very peculiar, yeah. Everything's peculiar, isn't it? Okay, let's see. We got a rocket. We got a pawn shop. I mean, normally bash RPGs for doing that. But... Spock is the kind of person to say what we all can... Yes, he is. He is Mr. Obvious. Very peculiar, Captain. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. Ah! You're hurting my crew. Kirk to Enterprise. Beam injured crew members back to ship. No articles. Okay, so which one is going up there? You both are down. You've got to be kidding me. So it's just me. Well. Spock is one down. Okay, so Spock is gone. McCoy is laying on the floor. I'm dead, Jim. Okay. Not awkward at all. Beam us up. And now you get up. We're gonna waste more of the ship's power as it decays orbit. Yeah, you can go. You can go. Okay. Spock, you seem to be better. Okay. Does anybody want to talk to me? I'm right here. Ah! Okay. Let's go back down to the surface. Oh, we can save. That's right. We can save this monstrosity. Your access code is that. Just like a work password. Excellent. I'll remember that in a heartbeat. Ship's computer. Interrupt that. conditions do not warrant alerts. Whatever. If I'm the captain, I say red alert. Fine. Okay, current landing party is fine. We have all the senior officers joining us, so when we all die, nobody can run the ship. Perfect. Let's go. We're about to have an intense dialogue. Captain, our most recent sensor report... yeah, we've had this conversation before. We've had this conversation before, Spock. You really want to wretch this all up. Fine. Just fine. Energize! Okay. Beep, 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 boop, 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 beep, beep. And there's no skip, by the way.
Ooh.
Okay, the deadly flowers are back. We're all back. Somehow the flower missed us. Okay, we got the flower. Yes, we will take a sample of it. So we can make our own repellent. To hell with the medicine man. Okay, we're gonna go up. Oh, I see the flower. Okay. Let's continue going upward. To the north! Now that we have access to that wonderful temple, we're going to make use of it. Alright, so since I actually have a few viewers out there today, what's your favorite Star Trek episode? I know a lot of people love The Trouble with Tribbles, and very understandably why. That is not my favorite episode, though. I have two favorites. Well, I love Trouble with Tribbles, don't get me wrong. That episode was hilarious. But the other one that people usually like is City on the Edge of Forever. Understandably, a brilliant episode. Wonderfully written. But I also have a thing for iMud, which I thought was hilarious. Okay, oh, boy, you just close up, don't you? I have to use item again now. Do I still have the item to use? Yes, I do. I have an eye key. Thank you, Macy. Okay. Yeah, Captain, yeah, the door opened up. Okay, now I gotta get ready. For when we get attacked by that doggy. I'm gonna strut in. Will it be all right? Yes, we've gone through this already. Hopefully there won't be more. All I know is that B button fires my phaser. That's all I care about. Oh, good Lord. Spock, Bones, get the hell out of the way. No, get out of the... Don't make me shoot you, Bones. Okay, yeah, over here. Okay, now get out of my way. I'm the leader. I go first. Okay, I'm pretty sure there's yet another doggy that will come and attack us. Okay. That's not abnormal at all. Only one person may pass these doors at a time. Everyone follow me through one at a time. Yeah, that's gonna work. Okay, so there are the symbols. Led Zeppelin style. Alrighty. Thank you. and I got shot. Okay, that didn't go well. Okay, that still didn't go well. And that went horribly bad. Let's see what my status is. Well, doesn't matter. I got shot. I could do it again. Yeah, the first symbol was this. The first symbol was not that. The captain is gravely injured, returning to Enterprise. Well, I can survive three, but not four. Let's talk to our fine crew. Perhaps they have something interesting to say. Sulu says, Mr. Sulu, status report. Our orbit is in slow decay, sir. We knew that. But I did ask, so that's on me. Mr. Chekhov, your report. Navigational systems are nominal, sir. Great. Thank you, Mr. Chekhov. Scotty. Mr. Scott, ship status. Working on backup impulse power only, Captain. You think that'd be able to keep the ship in orbit, though? I mean, think about it. What we know of Star Trek, backup impulse. I guess not. I don't know. Video game logic. Mr. Spock, sensor status. Nothing. Sensor readings indicate mineral deposits with moderate energy output on the planet's surface. Thank you, Dust. Bones! How is it going? We're a little shaken up, but we're okay. And then finally, Lieutenant Uhura. Status, please. He actually is nice. He says, please. Nothing but static, sir. Must be out of range. Yeah. Let's see. We're in unknown space. That's kind of how it works. Ship's computer. Interrupt that. There are no vessels in range for intership communication. Okay. I forgot about this. So this is where we are. We are here. And the Delta insignia points us orbiting that planet, which looks a lot like primitive Earth. But I'm glad it mentions that it's uncharted. Okay. Oh, wow. So unknown is a Class M, bearing 3, range 99, distance 0, mark 176. Set course, B choose another. Well, we can't get out of orbit, so it's kind of, you know, kind of pointless. Oh. That's where we are. We are here. There's a twin planet. Look at that. All right. You're already at this planet. Yeah, thank you. I'll figure that out. All right. We will try it again. Perhaps I should pay more attention as the landing party. Who can we change? Let's see. Next. Dr. McCoy. Yep, next. Specialist officer assigned by chief of department. Security officer, armed escort, and guard assigned from daily duty roster. A red shirt. Okay, let's choose a red shirt. Okay, so we got Spock and security. Done. Bones, you stay here. Because we're obviously going to need you. Oh, God. Do we have to go through this again? Do we really? Skip. Okay. There we go. And it's a true red shirt. Look at that. Not this red shirt, though. But you know who the badass red shirt was? Scotty. He even survived death. Thanks to Nomad. Who is perfect. Okay, so now I have two phaser-wielding people. Will he use it, though? He does use it. Why does the transporter officer look like a knockoff Kirk? Well, that could be like that could be like the stunt double. And he also has a phaser. He's shooting the plants without me telling him to do so. Oh my God, I love red shirts. You keep red shirting, you. Spock, God's sakes. Get over here. Okay. Here we go. Gotta watch out for the bloodworms. So, Kirk got, there are a lot of them this time. But Kirk got knocked out by guessing wrong. Which is very Kirk-like, I must admit. I should have Kirk come down with two red shirts. All Spock does is just tell us what's obvious. I mean, Spock thinks he's that smart. We all know better. Now, my wife's favorite character of Star Trek, by the way, London Lasses, was Mr. Scott. That's a fine choice, I will admit. And having met Mr. Doohan numerous times through the Star Trek conventions, yeah, nice, personable. Okay, now we have to use it. It keeps closing on us. We got Mr. Spock and we got Brad Garrett. Look at that. Okay, so we're going to use item. We're going to use the I key. Yeah. Thank you, Spock. Okay, so that's the first one. Then that. And then that. Get ready to shoot your phaser, and then the balls, and then the belt, and then the rocket. Okay, I see multiple phaser shots. Okay, then the hoo-ha, then the rocket, and then that thing again. And then the end. And then that, then the balls, then that. And then they warn us, one person at a time. Yep. It'll be me. Okay, so this was the first thing. Okay. This was the second thing. I think the belt was the third thing. Or was it the balls? It was not the balls. Okay, so I got hit. Now it's the balls. And then it was the belt. And then it was the rocket. It was not the rocket. Okay, that's twice I've been hit. Okay, then it's this thing. Nope. Then it's this thing. Nope. Alrighty, Captain is gravely injured again. We're doing great. Okay, that's twice I nearly died. Through my own ineptitude. Okay. So, the sing of the chicken man here, Vin. Doing that, you'll break the stream. Although there's a thing that will do that automatically. Alright. Hopefully this will work. Nope. Damn. Hang on. There we go. Okay. Perfect. Where were we? We're gonna beam down again. Thank you for the chicken dance. Appreciate it. Did I hit the B button? I hit the B button. Of course I did. Because B always comes before A on Nintendo controllers. Okay, so. Let's see. Do we really need Spock? I mean, think about it. So let's get rid of Spock. Let's replace him with somebody else. We got Spock, rank Lieutenant Commander, duty First Officer and Science Officer. Then we got McCoy, Leonard J., rank Lieutenant Commander, duty Chief Medical Officer. Then Specialist Officer assigned by Chief of Department. We have our choices of Geology, Biology, or History. Nah, we don't need no nerd. And then we have Security Officer. Now, we already have Brad Garrett on our team. Do we need another Brad Garrett? Probably not. Who will it go to next? Oh, it goes back to Spock. Okay. I want shooters. I want people who can shoot. Don't ask questions. Choose. Okay, so we got two Brad Garretts. Done. We got the perfect team. And he's falling asleep behind the transporter console. He's like, do I have to do this again? Yes, you do. Okay. Now let's see if we can actually do this right. Welcome to the second half of the stream here. I'm Super Pack Jr., retro streamer, and we're playing the best game ever. Star Trek 25th Anniversary, which came out a year after his 25th anniversary. Okay, so we gotta watch out. I want everyone shooting as much as possible. I want people shooting those shooty flowers. Like that. Exactly. Good. As long as we're all on the same team. Okay. Shoot the worms too, even though they don't do anything. You know what? F this noise. Everyone, put your phasers on kill. That's right. Starfleet won't know. They can't even hear us. I'm gonna drive the worms out. Oh, did you step on a worm? You idiot. Did I tell you to step on a worm? No. I think it's this way anyway. That's right, shoot the worms. Hey, the worms do die. Excellent. We can kill worms now. As long as you don't shoot me, that's okay. Get over here. What I love about this game, I don't care what you do. It plays out like a Star Trek episode. That is true. I'll give it that. It's not overreaction-y. Violence is not exactly acceptable. You're supposed to be thinking things through. It's a puzzle game. It's a puzzle adventure game. Which is unusual for this generation. Because everything had to be a shooty shoot, jumpy jump, platformy, whatever-y. And puzzles were like Tetris. Okay, back to our items. And our twin Brad Garrett. I-key. Captain, thank you. Thank you, not Spock. Appreciate it. Okay, so that's first. And then that's second. And then the rocket is third. The balls are fourth. The seat belt is fifth. And then the super rocket sixth. Okay. And you're already chasing us. Thank you, security officer. Oh, you sent more than one at us. Okay, so that's the order. Once again, we will get through this. Okay. Okay, Kirky. So the hoo-ha is first. That is second. The rocket's third. I didn't get shot. Next up are the balls, the seat belt, and the super rocket. Okay, and then this. Right. Then that. Nope, not that. That's my first mistake. Not too bad. This one? Nope. Okay. That's two. Alright. I lost track. And I got shot. Okay, one more shot and I'm done. Okay. Okay. The captain is stupid. He got hurt again. That's all he's good for. Exactly. Exactly. Okay, we will try this again. I'll keep my double Brad Garrett. And let's go. Now, will Spock be in the turbo lift with me? Nope. No conversation. Thank God. Talking about the same thing over and over again. This is almost as good as a Star Trek animated series episode, just to let you know. Almost as good. Oh, hurry up. Actually, we're going to take this time out because we got to do another commercial ad anyway. Okay, so we're going to pause the game eventually. There we are. I'm going to pause the game right here. I'm going to run a couple of minutes worth of ads just to satisfy the requirements of Twitch and get this thing out of the way. So we're going to hit the button that says pause, and we're going to run 2 minutes. Oh, turn off the timer first. There we go. Not get ahead of ourselves. We'll be right back. I'm going to run them together. So you hear the game's music on top of the idiot theme, we'll be just fine. It's been forever since I played this. So how's everyone doing? Having a good old time here. Now, I know they made this for DOS. And if you're too young to remember that, good for you. But they also made a Game Boy edition of this as well. It was a completely different game too, which is pretty cool. And it was a big time for Star Trek, 25 years back in the day. And just think, Star Trek Next Generation went off the air 30 years ago, May. So a couple months removed. And they were already working on the Generations movie at this time. That's amazing. And we can still talk and play and make fun of Star Trek to this day. Knowing that it's still a thing. Now, I don't know about you, I actually liked the Picard series, particularly the last season. And, you know, if you didn't, that's fine. I did. It literally was the 8th season of Star Trek Next Generation. And it was quite cool. But I love Star Trek Next Generation as much as I loved the original Star Trek. Once Season 3 got underway. We're almost done. I realized these two songs, you know, the intermission music, which is called Idiots on a Rampage. It's a lot faster. This is one of the slow vamps. And the Star Trek music do not mix whatsoever. My community's back. Hey, viewers. Listening to a cacophony of Star Trek wandering music and my Idiots on a Rampage theme. Yeah. It works. It works wonders, doesn't it? Okay, let's go back to the screen, shall we? Okay, so we have a full. We're not gonna stun around. No, because we're gonna full our phaser. So we're set to kill. And look at that! Look at that! They're all clones of each other. It's amazing, isn't it? Okay, let's wander around aimlessly. Knowing that there are flowers there that will kill us. And the flowers are dead. We already have a sample flower anyway, so there. Yep, shoot the flowers. And we can shoot the worms. Really? You seem to be stuck on the chicken dance there. Okay, chicken, this is not the first time you've done this today. Just settle down. Settle down. Okay, chicken, you got it. Okay. You broke the stream. Thanks, Vin. Thanks for breaking stream. Thanks. All right. I haven't done one of these in a while. All right, hang on. I gotta get it restarted. Hang on. There we go. Yeah, you stole one less thunder. Hang on. Okay. Let's try it again. Hang on. Come on. Okay. Hey. Jesus. No. Okay. Jesus. Try it again. Hang on. I'm sorry I'm boring you there. There we go. Alrighty. Okay. I think it's okay now. And let's go back to the game. Back to the game. That's what it felt like on Thursday. Okay, very good. Very retro. Indeed. Can't have enough of that. I should have the music back on there. There you go. Perfect. Okay, so here we are. With my killer crew. And our shooty-shoot phasers. London Lyles, welcome to the stream here. We're playing Star Trek the 25th Anniversary NES game from Interplay and Ultra Games. From 1992, which is not the 25th anniversary of Star Trek, but who's counting, right? And so far, our ship is going to decay orbit and will crash into the planet in less than 2 hours. So we're doing great. We're in uncharted space, by the way. And how do we know? Because we have a chart that says uncharted. Okay, wait a minute. Don't want my security guards to get too lost. Okay, now we have to go up there. Okay. Don't step on the worms, gents. What's wrong with y'all? So we run into killer plants, bloodworms, killer dogs, a temple. We should be wearing our bloodworm repellent that we so carefully got from the medicine man and the tribe, that we haven't violated prime directive just quite yet. Although our phasers are set to kill, that means that we will destroy life. I don't want to hear anything about, so Starfleet won't like that. Whatever. They're not here. Okay, so let's do this. We have our Brad Garrett security team. Music sucks? Yes, it does. Okay, use item. We're going to use the I key. Captain, there's a door. Yeah, great. Okay, so we got to remember these symbols. We have the first symbol is a hoo-ha. Second symbol is whatever that is. Scripture, I guess. We have a rocket. Then we have State Farm. We have a seat belt. And then a mega rocket. And then a hoo-ha again. Then a rocket. Oh, rocket. Okay. And then that thing. Okay. The rocket, then scripture. Gotcha. And then scripture again. And State Farm. Then another hoo-ha. Okay. I think I can do it this time. The wall is talking to me. Only one of you can go through. Blah, blah, blah. Men, stay here. I'll do everything. Okay, so it's a hoo-ha. Yeah. Then it's scripture time. Yep. And then it's a rocket. Yep. And then it's State Farm. Yep. Then it's a seatbelt. Then it's super rocket. And then it's another hoo-ha. Doesn't this look like, where's Spock, where's McCoy? They're not on my team, they're useless. I know what I'm doing. Okay, then it's another rocket. And then it's scripture time. Now here's where I screw up. Then it's another scripture. Right. And then it's State Farm. They're all dead? They're all dead. And then it's that. I missed. That's okay. 8 out of 9. We made it. How many times has Kirk died? Plenty. Oh, I can't save because I'm not on the Enterprise. That's okay. I have a phaser full. Kirk has died about 3 times now. Oh, there's more symbols. Okay, so I gotta use the rocket, the hoo-ha, and the seatbelt. And then the seatbelt, the scripture, State Farm, the hoo-ha, and seat rock. Thank you. Can I use the computer? Okay, so I got the rocket, the hoo-ha, the seatbelt again, the scripture, State Farm, the hoo-ha, super rocket, ordinary rocket, State Farm, and looks like it's the computer room. So I guess I use this computer. Here, I'm going to use this computer haphazardly. Here's my tricorder with Spock's arm. Captain! Hang on, Captain. More important things. Thank you. Hey, Darth Vader, how you doing? Your outfit sounds a little tight. Just a tad. Oh, my. Make sure you wash that thing, huh? Okay, so, Captain, I'm sure Mr. Spock would know more about this. Yeah, well, he's not here, so you figure it out there, security Brad Garrett. Captain, I'm sure Mr. Spock would know more about this. So, I can't go on without Mr. Spock. Are you effing kidding me? So, you two are just dumb. Are you kidding me? I chose unwisely. I sure did. All right, rub it in, guys. We're gonna keep trying. Brad Garrett knows all. Look at him. Isn't that Brad Garrett? Take a look at that face. You know I'm right. Thank you. Red shirts are expendable. Mr. Scott is not expendable, and he's a red shirt. And he's your favorite character, London Lass. Fine. Ugh. All ratings indicate nothing unusual, Captain. Deb, you can't tell me how to use this computer. Fine. Beaming up. Kirk to Enterprise. 3 to beam up. But he's a tough-ass Scotsman. I know that. And remember, Nomad killed him, and he survived that, too. Because Nomad brought him back to life, but, you know, whatever. I need at least one smart person on my team. Fine. Let's choose the transporter. I have to go through that puzzle one more time. We're gonna choose security, but we're gonna put Spock in the second person. And we choose Spock. All right, so we got security, who's more important than Spock, then Spock, and now we're done. Which means we're gonna have to have that stupid conversation once again. Oh my God, Captain, our most recent sensor report revealed a. See how long this will last. No one's more important than Spock. That is true. I will agree with that. Hell, they made a whole movie of finding him, remember? The search for Spock? After he died, sacrificing his life to save the crew of the Enterprise? We have 37 minutes. We can do it. It tells you how also big this ship is, knowing that this conversation will never end until I hit the A button. So by this time, the turbolift must be going through the Enterprise's hull right now and into deep space. Large deposit of the lithium under a very... Why does Spock smile? I can see... Yeah, he kind of does. But there, he's not smiling now. And you look, they even tried to get the Delta Shield insignia correct, where Kirk has a little star and Spock has the double circle. Unusual structure. Oh, get this conversation over with Jesus. Ah! Okay. Here's the transporter room. Energize! A proper landing party. Kirk, Spock, and some future dead guy. Okay, so now I have one less shooty-shoot thing. So I only have two phasers set to kill. Which I will do right now because it automatically defaults back to stun. We can't have that. Okay, full effect. As opposed to saying the actual word kill. We have to navigate through this thing. Okay, we eliminated the plant. We eliminated that plant too. We can't have those plants. Don't hear the transporter, it was there. It's not as magnificent. The NES sound system can only do so much. Okay, they're the bloodworms. Now we can shoot them and use them as fish food. Spock, this is why I don't keep you around. You've got to be kidding me. You've got to be kidding me. Really? This is what we reduced to. No, I'm not stunning plants. No. I'm killing them. But this is what we've done. This is what we are. Okay. Yep. I made him stop. And now, yeah. Okay. Made him stop again. It's like red light, green light. Green light. Red light. Green light. Red light. I need to move Spock. Yeah, that worked. Oh, there you go. Okay, here we go. We're gonna randomly shoot stuff too. You watch out for the bloodworms. I noticed that they seem to run away from us, which is not a bad thing per se. We gotta go up here. Not minding that one bit. Okay. We can do it. Okay, come on, red shirt. Don't be dumb Spock. I love just tapping on the D-pad. makes them move all over the place. I'm not even moving. I'm just barely tapping the D-pad. I love the game mechanics in this game. Okay. Right, B button shoots your phaser. This is what we... Don't shoot me. Why did he jump for joy? I don't know. Okay. Once again, the door is closed behind us, so we have to use our key. There we go. Yes. Okay, so once again, memorize these symbols. We got the hoo-ha, the scripture, ordinary rocket, State Farm, seatbelt, big old rocket, another hoo-ha. That was close. Ordinary rocket, scripture. Really, Spock? Why does it say fluff? Does it say fluff? Okay, our security guard has been hurt. Ironically. Well, not so ironically. Okay. Stay out of the doorway, Spock. Scripture, State Farm, hoo-ha. And then you guys. Yeah, I'm going in anyway. Only one person may pass at a time. That'll be me. Okay. So, once again, it's hoo-ha. Then it's scripture. And then it's State Farm. Nope, it's not State Farm. It's Ordinary Rocket. Okay, well, I'm through anyway. Then it's State Farm. Then it's Seatbelt. And it's Mega Rocket. Okay, and it's back to you. And then it's Ordinary Rocket. And then it's Scripture. And I think it's back to hoo-ha. Nope, it's not back to hoo-ha. Stop shooting me! Jesus. Are you kidding me? Ah! All right. Back to the transporter room. That's our landing party. And we have to go through this conversation again. So we'll just repeatedly hit A. Oh my god. Okay. Here we go. Energize! And he's like, again? Fine. It's what you pay me for. You know, I never thought of it, London Lass. You're absolutely right. The transporter effect is just way too silent. Is not loud enough. Should sound something like this. That'd be cool. Okay, so here we are. Where the hell are you going? Bye bye, flower. Okay, flower's dead. No more flower. Kill that flower too, just for posterity. I mean, if they really want to do that, could have had those things that, you know, slap you on the back and stuff like that. Those little mozzarella things. But no. Okay. Heading up to the thingy. We did kill Dr. McCoy at one point. We also killed Spock. Everything's just fine. When you go through that temple, it says fluff. Does it? Well, if we ever get there, that amoeba thingy. Yeah, the amoeba thingy. Spock, swear to God. You're worse than children. It's like walking through a mall. Yeah, shoot the worms. That's right. That's right. That's right. Shoot the worms. Shoot the worms. Okay. Okay, we're at the temple. And once again it's locked. I just want to see what they do. Yep. Yep. Just like Star Trek. You know, this is just like watching an episode of Star Trek. I mean, this is absolutely normal. Okay, we're going to use the I key once again. Fluff. Okay, you know what? I see it now. And the door just closes. Well, if anything, it says. So you got an F here, an F here. Yeah, or fluff. Like I said, it's fluff. Works for me. Oh, I hit the wrong freaking button. Okay, yeah. Thank you, Spock. Thank you. Yeah, let's see if I can actually get inside this time and get to that computer. Okay, so once again, it's the hoo-ha scripture. Ordinary rocket, State Farm, seatbelt, big ol' rocket. Okay, and you hurt Spock. We'll be all right. The creature is merely stunned. Whoa. When did we set it? Okay, so Spock got hurt. You rock, Spock. That's right. Okay, so ordinary rocket scripture. Go through this again, because another creature will be coming by to ravage us. So once again, one last, I'm going to need your help. We got the hoo-ha, the scripture, ordinary rocket, State Farm, seatbelt, big ol' rocket, hoo-ha. We killed the creature. I don't hear anyone complaining. Ordinary rocket scripture. Okay. Then after scripture, we have scripture again. State Farm, hoo-ha. Okay. We can get through this. Okay, so it's, once again, it's hoo-ha. Yep. Then it's scripture. You asked the right one. I guess I did. Then it's ordinary rocket. Yes. Then State Farm. Seatbelt. Mega rocket. Then it's back to hoo-ha. Ordinary rocket. Scripture. Scripture again. Ooh, what's next? Doesn't matter, because I can get through this now, because I've not been hurt. I think State Farm. I am right. And then Mega Rocket. Nope, wrong. Picked wrong once. All right, we got through. That's all that matters. And I have Mr. Spock. Okay. So then more symbols. We got Rocket Hoo-Ha, Seatbelt. Seatbelt Scripture, State Farm Hoo-Ha, Mega Rocket, Ordinary Rocket, and then State Farm Scripture and Mega Rocket. Spock says, Captain, this computer was created by a race far more superior than the native population. From what I can comprehend, this machine requires an incredible amount of energy to create the necessary material for life to exist on this planet. This power can only be generated by a vast supply of dilithium crystals. That's all you can tell me? So we made it. I brought you here just to tell me that kind of crap. Okay. Okay, we need to continue. See, my problem is it's a dead end. There's no way out. So this computer is so energy consumption wise, it needs, it's probably draining the Enterprise. Well, the Enterprise went through an unknown series of gravitational fluxes that flung it out into uncharted space. Okay, so what do I do now? Uh-huh. I can only hypothesize that these tiles are some kind of activating mechanism standing in front of the proper tiles in the proper sequence may activate the computer. Oh, joy. Okay, so. Okay. All right, so we got to... Aha! Okay, so that's the first one. So let's take these six tiles over here. We got Rocket, Hoo-Ha, and Seatbelt. So we got Rocket, Hoo-Ha, Seatbelt, and of course we're going to cheat because we're going to just gander over here. State Farm Scripture and Mega Rocket. Okay, so we got State Farm Scripture, Mega Rocket. Pretty. Fascinating. Apparently, a druid can activate the computer by musical tones. Another item of interest, Captain. On the wall is a map of the local region of space. I'm recording the information now. You do that, Spock. You do that. Okay, so all the computers are now on. But this is the only apparently useful one. Captain, this computer was created by a race far more... Okay, you've already told us. Yeah, it's very Zelda-like. You're right. Yeah, you're repeating yourself, Spock. Come on, man. Yeah, we know about the crystals. Okay, so now what? Ah, a door opens up. It could be a trap. I hope it is. Ooh. Well, there's dilithium crystals right there. Tricorder. This appears to be a large deposit of low-grade dilithium. Crystals. The quantity we should require should not interfere with running of this machinery. I shall give these coordinates to Mr. Scott so he may beam them directly aboard the Enterprise. Yes, do that. Kirk to the Enterprise. Three to beam up. We did it! We can now escape orbit. We saved the Enterprise. We're no longer going to crash into that planet. I feel so proud of myself. We have 20 minutes to spare almost. Okay, there's Scotty. There's Turbo Lift. There's Uhura listening out for who knows, because there's nothing out there. And Spock will give himself a permanent hernia. Now let's see what everyone has to say. Starting with Spock. Sensor status. Status. Sensors detect nothing unusual, Captain. Okay, that's good for once. I mean, that's nice. Scotty? Ship status. It's these crude crystals, Captain. It won't be much longer before they give out completely. Really? 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 So, we didn't do crap. Okay, and Uhura, she's listening out for anything. There's nothing there. No one's there. All right, well, let's see. Let's go to our map here. We're in uncharted space, and that place apparently is called Massaba. Oh, we got names now. Megalith, Lapith, Ibex, Kappa. What the hell? Acanthus? Who came up with these names? Hooray, yeah. A pandana, sure. Oh, Romulan Empire, that's what. So we're near the Romulan thingy thing. What the hell? Lekithos. And then there's Chol, Garthos, Meyer, Tartalus, Rotron, Kallion, Dromos, Sithoi, Gurga. We have the neutral zone, which has Shroud. And then Usins in the United Federation planet, like Kaldora, Kashmir. There you are. Tavarius, Temoku, Eosia, Arcos, Altamira. Don't cross the neutral, I shall not. And Mekel. Okay, so we got. It's funny, there's no Earth, there's no Vulcan. There we are. So we're in uncharted space. We wound up all the way over here. Fine. Let's go over here. Megalith is a Class L planet, bearing 3. You will set course. Mr. Chekhov, plot a course. Course plotted. And laid in, sir. What quadrant? I have no idea. It's uncharted space. It's not the Delta quadrant, if that's what you're asking. Spock says, approaching our destination, Captain. You know, Chekhov could have told me that too, you know. So the impulse, standard orbit, Mr. Sulu. Aye, Captain. We should see a planet in the view screen anytime now. Anytime now. Up, there's a planet right there. Yay. All right. Now in standard orbit, sir. That's what I want to hear, Mr. Sulu. That's what I want to hear. All right. Let's beam down. Red alert. Civ's computer interrupt 204 AMX. Conditions do not warrant alert status at this time. I want red alert. I want it now. Okay, we're going to go down with this usual security, landing party. Now what? You look concerned, Spock. My concern regards the condition necessary for dilithium crystal formation. Why should that bother you? I have computed the odds of all necessary conditions existing on this planet. Simultaneously, at any point in the planet's history. And what was your conclusion? I think you would rather not know, Captain. Oh, wow. Really gonna do that, Spock. Okay, we're a brand new planet. Fascinating, indeed. Ring. Here we are. Yeah. Okay, this is taking far too long. Hey! Oh, check out the music.
I gotta turn that up. Hang on.
Track order reading show a barren, desolate world, Captain. I'm just waiting for the what up music. Track order reading show a barren, desolate world, Captain. I doubt there is anything of interest here. Tricorder readings are picking up nothing, Captain. What if you're wrong? You ever think of that, guys? I'm the captain here. Of this here ship. I'm your captain. I'm getting mightily sick. Okay. They just walk around aimlessly. That's right, Spock. You just stay there. Idiot. Sort of recognize it, yeah. My Shatner impersonation? I'm not trying. I'm not even trying anymore. Mr. Spock, shoot to kill. Okay, so there's nothing here. Fine. Beam us up. Okay. So this planet is useless. Okay, I can deal with that. It's fine. We're here to explore strange new life forms and civilizations. Wasn't any here. That's fine. It's okay. We're going back to our star charts. So nothing on Megalith. What about Lapith? Okay, it's a class L. It's breathing. And we will set course. Here we go. We're going to use what we can of these crystals to explore all these planets. Okay. Slow impulse, blah, blah, blah. Okay, we should see a planet come into screen right about anytime those stars stop moving. There we go. Yeah, red planet. Red-ish planet. With a bunch of holes in it. All right, we're going down. Okay, good. Okay, let's go. Captain, the geological age of this planet is too short for any sustainable mineral deposits to form. Understand, Ms. Spock. However, even very young dilithium crystals would be better than no crystals at all. So this is a brand new planet, according to Spock. Let's go. A brand new young planet without any crystals. Shifty-eyed Kirk, yeah. He trusts no one, not even his best friend. Ah, much better looking. Words of wisdom, Spock. Tricorder readings show a barren, desolate world, Captain. I doubt there is anything of interest here. You're such a bearer of bad news, Spock. Just for that, we're setting our phasers to kill. Okay? Okay. And we're gonna shoot rocks and stuff. I mean, does all planets have to have stuff to keep you happy, Spock? They already want to strip it? Yeah. Okay. So, Spock says this is a new planet. Kind of like what happened to Genesis. Genesis? Yes, Genesis. We come in peace, shoot to kill, indeed. Start trekking across the universe. Okay, fine, you win, Spock, yet again. Kirk to Enterprise, 3 to beam up. I'm their Captain Kirk. We come and be a shoot to kill. Okay, fine. Nothing there. Jeez. We're going to waste our crystals finding other planets. We were there at Massa, blah, 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 blah. Now we can go to Ibex. Doesn't Ibex sound like a vacation planet of sorts? Class L. They're all Class L. Bearing 3. Mark that, blah, blah. Set a course. That's where we're going to go. Okay, we're setting a course. We're plotting a course. That's all Chekhov's good for right now. We should be there in no time. Mr. Spock says, Captain, destination in range. We need a Class M. Okay, standard orbit, here we come. Let the stars stop moving for a second. In comes the planet. It is a blue planet. It is a holy blue planet. Okay. Now, we're going to talk to Spock so we don't waste our time going down there. This is Spock, sensor status. And he says, sensors detect nothing. Oh, God. So we have to go down to the planet for you to tell me there's nothing there. Fine. Let's do that. All water could be. We don't know because Spock's not really trying now, is he? You look concerned, Spock. My concern regards the conditions necessary, blah, blah, blah. We already had this discussion. I'm not talking to you anymore. You're mean to me. Yeah. Okay, here we go. Energizing. They did try hard. That means nothing, yeah. That's right. Okay, there they go. This is almost as good as an animated episode. Okay, well, lots of holes. Okay, bad news or good news, Spocky? Spock says, tricorder readings. Pick up nothing, Captain. F you, Spock, okay? Fall down the ditch, will you? Can we at least move around the board here a little? Okay, it's a big nothing field. Kind of reminds me of E.T. You know, with all those pits all over the place, just haphazardly around. You fall into. And the security guard's now getting lost. There's nothing here. That's great. All right, cool. Just like a regular episode of Star Trek. Without a clue to tell us where to go next, used our mappy. Still in uncharted space. We're going to go to Kappa. Because Kappa's cool. It is a Class A planet. All right. We're going to beam down and die. Like I said, except you're not falling. Yeah. Okay, Spock, you're going to tell us. Sensors indicate we have arrived, Captain. Thank you, Spock. That's what the view screen's there for, too. We're Phi Beta? I don't know. Beta Kappa, Kappa Beta. Roger, Roger. Vector, Victor. That doesn't look ideal. We're going to beam down anyway. Okay. Landing party. Ship's computer atmospheric temperatures varies between 290 degrees and minus 320. I want to beam down anyway. Come on. Because we have a red shirt after all. He has to die, right? Okay. The ship's computer interrupts. You're not going to let us go there. Fine. Ship's looking after us. Acanthus. Not a good idea to send him alone? I guess not. It's a Class L planet. Okay. So Class A is bad. Wide varying temperatures. Approaching our destination, Captain. Thank you, Mr. Spock. Thank you for stating the obvious yet again. Okay, here comes the planet. As soon as that star gets out of the view screen, there it is. Looks like Earth. Now in standard orbit. Okay, cool. Can we beam down this one? It's a Class L. There's our landing party. We're going to the turbo lift. Yeah. Captain, although this planet is geologically primed for formation of dilithium crystals, our odds of finding any may be slim. Thanks for the optimism there, Mr. Spock. I'm glad you're aboard here. Markings on the planet's surface indicate heavy mining activities. Some markings are similar to those made by the landing skids of mineral pirates vessels. Ah, we could be an adventure time. Class M? Nope, it's Class L. Which is breathable. We're in the Star Trek Trekkians. Okay, there we go. The more you know. I feel smarter already. Okay, well, there's vegetable life, apparently. Okay, and Mr. Spock says, tricorder rings are picking up nothing, Captain. You just told us this place could have dilithium crystals. You told us there was activity of miners. Now you're picking up nothing? What is it? Which way is it? Fine. And just for you, I'm going to set my phaser on full. Okay? Okay? There we go. Mr. Spock says moo. So this place has been raided of its dilithium already, according to Mr. Spock. And it's the same screen over and over again. We may have to cross the neutral zone because of you. Can't go up, can only go left and right. And it's the same board formation over and over again. We're gonna leave you there, Spock. But you came back anyway. So your concern in the turbo lift was just utter bullshit then. Is that what that is? Fine. We only have a minute and 23 seconds left anyway. Da, 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 da. All right, next planet of nothing is a Pandana. Now remember, we need dilithium crystals to get out of this Class B planet. Oh, good. We're all going to suffocate. Perfect. This will be our... My mother would not be pleased if you leave me behind. Yes. That's what's indicated. We have arrived, Captain. Thank you for using your sensors to tell me what I see on the screen there, Spock. Your mother Amanda would be thanking me, Mr. Spock. She's tired of your crap, too. Okay. It's a more bluish planet. Okay, now in standard orbit. That's great. Okay, let's go get our landing party ready. We have 12 seconds. Gaseous and unstable atmosphere is extremely corrosive, so we'll just shoot it with our phasers then. Fine, jeez. Is there any planet here that has anything? It's a Class L. Okay. We're gonna leave it there. Well, that's Star Trek, the 25th anniversary. It was a pretty cool game, I have to admit. It literally was doing what you would expect in the Star Trek episode. And they did try awfully hard, I will say that. But considering the audience that normally plays an NES versus something like this, they may not necessarily mix. But that was my 19th birthday present, so hey, there you go. Alrighty. We're going to leave the computer running in the background, too. It was something, yeah. Well, like I said, I haven't played in forever. And it was a lot of fun, so. Like I said, I had a good time playing it. But then again, that was back when I was young and stupid. So, if you like what you saw, hopefully you did, give me a follow. We'd greatly appreciate it. You can also like and subscribe to my YouTube channel with past streams that are no longer found on here. Wish Mother happy birthday. Yep. Oh, yeah, that's right. Happy birthday, mother-in-law. Today is Sharon's birthday. Yay. Hey, all right. There's also an Instagram page out there, my crap, that I've been collecting over the last 48 years of gaming. There's a Twitter page out there telling you when I'm doing something stupid, like this. And there's Discord out there. So, we're going to go ahead and run off. Have a great weekend. She be old. You notice I did not mention that, London Lass. Did not mention that. But, yeah. Anyway, having said that, you can also check out Billy Jackson's graphics, his artwork, if you will. Like what you see here on the screen, twitter.com/BillyGraphics. Some jackass did the music. And have yourself a great weekend. We'll see you Monday night. Continue on with Final Fantasy II for Super Nintendo. Bye. Then I've discovered I'm older than most of Twitch. Not all, most.